The U.S. sets yet another COVID-19 vaccination target. President Joe Biden wants 70% of adults in the country vaccinated against COVID-19 with at least one dose by the July 4 Independence Day holiday. He also calls on young people to get inoculated. So far, nearly 150 million Americans have received at least one shot, and over 105 million Americans have been fully vaccinated. Biden's new goal comes as his administration faces new delays in administering vaccines, with more people growing hesitant to get inoculated.
Now we're going to have to bring the vaccine to people who are less eager. So we also know that there are millions of Americans who just need a little bit of encouragement to get the shot. I recently called on employers to do their part by offering paid time off for employees to get vaccinated and opening up a tax credit program that reimburses the businesses for the cost of giving the employee the time off to get vaccinated. And I want to thank the 1,000 businesses that have stepped up so far.
Biden had previously announced July 4th as a target date for when Americans can gather in small groups to signal a return to greater normalcy in the middle of a pandemic. Well, COVID-19 infections in India soar past 20 million. As this report tells us, the country's worsening crisis prompted the suspension of its largely popular cricket league.
India's first drive-in vaccination facility opened on Tuesday in Mumbai as coronavirus infections in the hard-hit country surged past 20 million amid growing calls for a national lockdown. As COVID-19 tears through the country, experts say many cases are going undetected. The surge has coincided with a dramatic drop in vaccinations due to supply and delivery problems. But on Tuesday, the elderly and those most at risk in Mumbai poured into the vaccination center to get their jabs while staying in their cars. And even though aid is now coming in from other countries, India's healthcare system is falling apart. Hospitals are running out of beds and oxygen and unable to help many who are critically ill. The situation is so dire that the country's beloved cricket league was suspended on Tuesday. With an estimated brand value of nearly $7 billion, the Indian Premier League tournament had been played without spectators to huge TV audiences, but has been severely criticized for continuing while the healthcare system is in collapse. Also being criticized, Prime Minister Narendra Modi's government for allowing religious festivals and political gatherings attended by hundreds of thousands of people to go on. Now his government is reluctant to impose a national lockdown for fear of the economic fallout. In response, opposition leader Rahul Gandhi has said a national lockdown was desperately needed and that it was the, quote, only option.
G7 countries seek to form a common front toward China as they met for their first in-person talks since the COVID-19 pandemic began. They devoted their first session Tuesday in London to China and its growing authoritarian threat. U.S. Secretary of State Antony Blinken pledged robust cooperation with Britain in pressuring China over the Xinjiang region, where 1 million Uyghurs are reportedly detained. British Foreign Secretary Dominic Raab, meanwhile, wants to hold Beijing to its commitment on Hong Kong, which was promised a separate system until 2047. But Blinken clarified the U.S. does not want to hold China down. Instead, it wants to uphold the international rules-based order. The group of seven is made up of most advanced nations, namely the U.S., U.K., Canada, France, Germany, Italy, and Japan. Myanmar's ambassador to the United Nations tells U.S. lawmakers more sanctions on the Myanmar's junta's assets are needed. Ambassador Kwal Motun wants Washington to impose sanctions on a state-owned Myanmar foreign trade bank and the state-run Myanmar oil and gas enterprise. The Biden administration has already slapped sanctions on the military generals who led the February 1 coup, as well as family members and businesses that provide them with revenue.
I wish to appeal to you and the House of Representatives as follows. To save lives of innocent civilians, protection should be immediately extended to the people of Myanmar. I wish to stress that Myanmar is not just witnessing another major setback to democracy, but also the crisis is threatening the regional peace and security. In line with the principle that a state has the responsibility to protect its own people from crimes against humanity, the NUG, together with the people, have taken all possible ways and means to defend our own people from the military's inhumane and brutal acts.